But Carhuaz is now prepared, says the town's head of civil defense, Luis Mesa.
Nosotros como autoridades lo que necesitamos es trabajar en el tema de hacer mucha prevención. O sea, nosotros debemos saber hacer, de tener en cuenta de hacer esto antes de que ocurra. Y qué mejor que tener un sistema que te pueda avisar con tiempo y en tiempo real qué es lo que está pasando. Y es más, verlo, porque hay cámaras, ¿no? Claro que el clima a veces no lo permite, pero nosotros ya tenemos la seguridad de una información en tiempo real.
Working out of this tiny office, Mesa heads up the 24-hour monitoring.
La población tiene en cuenta eso y ahora es muy sensible a este tema de la situación de un eventual aluvión, no solo por la probabilidad de la ocurrencia de un sismo, sino por el mismo hecho del descongelamiento o del retroceso glaciar producto del calentamiento global.
It's an important start, but experts say there's still another 34 glacial lagoons which could overflow, putting at risk the lives of tens of thousands in the valley of the River Santa, which runs through the White Mountain Range. The most densely glaciated mountain range in the tropics, Peru's Cordillera Blanca, is a touchstone for the study of climate change. For these farmers, the glaciers served as ice stocks, locking up water as ice and slowly releasing it into the rivers during the dry season. But in their lifetimes, says Alejandro Cruz, they've seen this chain of icy mantles gradually disappear.
Más anterior, cuando éramos niños, las ciales era lleno de estas nevadas, todos los cerros. Ahorita nosotros hemos formado una institución de trekking, caminata con extranjeros. Vemos cuando viene un cliente ya ven así estación ya negro, cerro nomás ya. Más antes era negro, nevadas.
But the effects are as complex as they are at times bewildering. Although it's clear that eventually there will be much less water, the problem they face now is not one of quantity, but quality. One of the unforeseen side effects of glacial melt is that the water running off the glaciers now is increasingly more acidic. This is the Rio Negro, or Black River, but it's turning increasingly more red in color as heavy metals leach out of newly exposed rocks further upstream. As the glacier retreats, rocks are exposed to the elements for the first time, sometimes in tens of thousands of years.
The uncovering of these metal-rich rocks because of the ice retreat has been exposing all these rocks and metals to oxygen and to the air. So there are many complex processes, physical, chemical, and biological processes also, that are increasing the acidity of water, which in the long term, and it's already happening now, it's deteriorating water quality.
Dr. Raul Loaiza is an aquatic toxicologist at Lima's Cayetano Heredia University. He and his team are studying the process and trying to find a way to mitigate the effects.
What we've seen so far is that a very good strategy is to use the nature, local biodiversity, in this case plants, for example, and that have an extraordinary capacity to accumulate metals in the roots, in the leaves, in the stems. So the idea is to make a broad survey of these plants across the year, of course, and to select the potential candidates related to their capacity to trap metals, for example, to absorb metals, and to use them later in a wetland system.
Wetlands and pasture lands may also be key for storing water as the ice stocks in the glaciers disappear. One of the farmers, Vicente Salvador, explains they want to use these huge highland expanses like a sponge, which holds and slowly releases the water.
Este pasto es para justo reservado para primer lugar para nuestro ganado, ganado lanar o vacuno que estamos en el campo nosotros. Y segundo caso es para poder cosechar agua para ver. Y este pasto, cuanto más pasto, ya forma su mantillo, cuando hay más mantillo, más maco del pasto, así cuando tiene, ya deposita más agua.
They're adapting because they have no choice. Climate change is also making the weather more extreme. There are more rains, more droughts, and more frosts, says Jerónimo Salvador.
Estamos observando en las estas papas, ¿no? Una enfermedad que nosotros llamamos la rancha negra. Eso es por defecto de mucha humedad, o sea, demasiada lluvia. Por ejemplo, esto parece quemado.
And pests are now found at higher altitudes. Industry, farming, hydroelectric generation, and an expanding population are all demanding more water. Yet as the planet warms, there will inevitably be less. Living so close to nature, the hundreds of thousands of people living in the White Mountains of Peru have been among the first to feel the effects of climate change. But forewarned is forearmed, and they may just be better prepared than many to face what global warming has to throw at them.
Our thanks to Dan Collins for that report.